Hello students, today we are going to start module 3 of your engineering thermodynamics. So in this module we are going to start a new chapter, that is vapor power cycle. So before we discuss about this vapor power cycle in a detailed manner, let us discuss what is power cycle. A power cycle continuously converts heat into work, in which a working fluid repeatedly performs a succession of processes. So this succession of processes we discuss in a detailed way or in one by one manner by using steam power plant. So as we all know, this steam power plant is considered to be an example of an heat engine. So this steam power plant runs on an ideal cycle that is known as Rankine cycle. The Rankine cycle is an idealized thermodynamic cycle of a heat engine that converts heat into mechanical work while undergoing a phase change. So remember students, this phase change is very important in this Rankine cycle or in this vapor power cycle. So before we discuss about the processes included in the Rankine cycle, we discuss about the basic components of the steam power plant, that is boiler, turbine, condenser and pump. So these are considered to be the basic components. So let us start from this boiler. This boiler, in which the water is boiled by means of the burning of the coal in the furnace. So where we added heat energy. So this heat energy addition process takes place at constant pressure. So remember, this constant pressure process is very important here. So next to the boiler is a turbine. So from boiler the steam is generated, and this steam is maybe considered to be wet in nature, maybe dry saturated in nature, may be superheated in nature. So according to its nature, that is wet, dry saturated and superheated, we have to draw the coordinate diagram, that is TS diagram or HS diagram, which we discuss later on. So next is turbine. So in form of state 1, the steam is entered to the turbine, which may be wet in nature, dry saturated in nature or superheated in nature. So in turbine, the process which is considered, that is reversible adiabatic expansion process, where we considered the process is undergoing by keeping entropy to be constant. So during this process, work is produced by the turbine, which is further transmitted to the generator, which is further transmitted to the generator, which is connected to this turbine. And this turbine considered, that is, or you can say this turbine considered to be producing work, which is further transmitted to the generator, and this generator will convert this mechanical work into electrical work. So next we consider about the condenser. This condenser, in which the heat is rejected by the steam, and after rejecting heat energy, that steam becomes water. And here we consider this water must be the saturated liquid water. Now this saturated liquid water is, again, we have to feed back to the boiler by means of this pump. And this pump considered to be, the process which is considered to be in the pump must be the reversible adiabatic compression process. And if it is reversible adiabatic, so it means we have to consider the process must be takes place by keeping entropy constant, which we will considered, which we will shown on this TS and HS diagram. And remember, this HS diagram is considered to be the Mollier diagram. The other name of this HS diagram is known as Mollier diagram. Sometimes in examination, it is asking that draw the Mollier diagram for a steam power plant or for the vapor power cycle. So basically, for this whole cycle, that is the Rankine cycle, or you can say the vapor power cycle, or simply you can say the heat engine. For this heat engine, here we are going to measure the performance of the heat engine or the performance of the Rankine cycle, or you can say performance of the vapor power cycle. So here we have to discuss the efficiency of the heat engine or efficiency of the Rankine cycle or efficiency of the vapor power cycle, right? So before we consider the efficiency, so we must know how this heat is added to the system, that is to the boiler, and how the heat is rejected by the condenser, how the work is produced by the turbine, and how the work is done on the pump. So the expressions for this heat addition, heat rejection, work done by the system and work done on the system, we have to understood the steady flow energy equation. As we all know, what is steady flow energy equation? Steady flow energy equation is an equation in which we consider the energy entering to the system must be, the rate of flow of energy entering to the system must be equal to the rate of flow of energy leaving the system. So there we considered the various types of energies like kinetic energy, potential energy, enthalpy, heat flow, work flow, etc. So here we consider one basic components like boiler, turbine, condenser, and that is pump. So by considering individual component, boiler, turbine, condenser, and pump, we write down the steady flow energy equations. So which is like, for a boiler, we consider to this boiler heat is added, that is Q1, energy is added, that is entering, that is H4, and energy which is leaving, that is H1. So according to the steady flow energy equation, that is Q1 plus H4 equal to H1. So that is Q equal to H1 minus H4. So what is the expression of Q1? That is H1 minus H4. Similarly, for turbine, what is the energy entering and leaving? Energy entering, that is H1, and energy leaving, that is WT plus H2. So according to the inlet and outlet conditions, we have considered H1 equal to WT plus H2, that is WT equal to H1 minus H2. Similarly, for condenser, what is the energy entering and leaving? That is H2 is entering and Q2 plus and H3 are leaving. So according to the steady flow energy equation, it is H2 equal to Q2 plus H3. So Q2 equal to H2 minus H3. Similarly, we consider for the pump, that is, what is the energy entering? That is H3 and WP, and leaving, that is H4. So according to the steady flow energy equation, that is H3 plus WP equal to H4. Right? So these are the heat addition, that is work produced by the system, heat rejection by the system, and work done on the system. So by considering these parameters, we are going to explain the efficiency. So efficiency, as we all know, that is Q1 minus Q2 by Q1, or it is equal to WT minus WP by Q1. So that we already discussed, or already we know in the first law of thermodynamics of the chapter. So by using that formula, we can get the performance of the Rankine cycle or vapor power cycle, or you can say the steam power plant. Now let us discuss the TS diagram and HS diagram. So see, there is a dome, it is a TS diagram, there is a dome, and this dome is known as the saturated dome. To the left hand side of this saturated dome, it is known as the saturated liquid line, and to the right hand side, it is known as saturated vapor line. Right? Now see, we consider all the processes which is considered in boiler, turbine, condenser, and pump on this TS diagram. So see, this 4-to-1 process, that is for the boiler, and this in boiler, which process is considered? That is constant pressure heat addition process. So constant pressure heat addition process, that is 4-to-1, where we consider that is pressure to be constant. And already we discussed the state which is generated from the boiler, it may be wet. If it is wet, this is 1 double dash. If it is dry saturated, that is 1 dash. And if it is superheated, that is 1. And now in the turbine, which process is considered? That is reversible adiabatic expansion process. As expansion process, it means pressure and temperature both decreases, and the state which is leaving the turbine is considered to be wet in nature. So it may be that is wet in nature, that is 2 dash or 2 double dash. If it is superheated 1, so it is 2. If it is dry saturated 1 dash, it is 2 dash. If it is 1 double dash, it is 2 double dash. But the process must be considered to be at constant entropy, which is shown on this TS diagram. Now next is the condenser. In condenser, which process is going on? That is at constant pressure heat rejection process. So constant pressure, that is written here P2 equal to constant pressure heat rejection. So as heat is rejected, so after rejection of energy, the steam becomes liquid, and this liquid is assumed to be the saturated liquid. So that's why this saturated liquid is represented on this saturated liquid line. Now next is pump. So in pump, which process is considered? That is reversible adiabatic compression process. So as reversible adiabatic process, it means again entropy is constant, which is shown on this 3 to 4 process. And here as it is compression, it means the pressure increases as well as temperature increases. So this is on the TS diagram. Similarly, we have to consider on the HS diagram. As HS diagram, so this is the saturated dome, and to the left hand side of this point, it is known as saturated liquid line, and to the right hand side, it is considered to be the saturated vapor line, and this is the constant pressure line, and this is also constant pressure line. So 4 to 1 process, again constant pressure heat addition process. 1 to 2 process, reversible adiabatic expansion process. 2 to 3 process, constant pressure heat rejection process. And 3 to 4 is considered to be reversible adiabatic compression process. So thank you students, I think you all understood this Rankine cycle. So next we are going to discuss in the next class about some modifications of the Rankine cycle and the comparison of this Rankine cycle with the Carnot cycle, like this. Okay, thank you again.